Embrace the beings around you with your heart and soul, and just allow your heart to be big enough to embrace the world of agape here first. See the beautiful light, the luminosity shining through all of these beings. They are the light that lights up every man and every woman that cometh into the world. Begin to see that with your inner eye and bless these beings. Expand your awareness and bless all the beings who are streaming in from around the globe, creating centers of coherence, centers of love and peace right where they are, whether they're in their living room or whether groups of them, individuals, are gathering to celebrate the divine life and the divine love that animates us all. And then see all of that beauty in the person, one of the persons sitting right next to you. Just allow the floodgates of your heart to open beyond your surface mind and look at that being and say, oh my God, I get to sit next to you. And you get to sit next to me. There's so much joy in us. Dynamic peace resides within us. Infinite possibilities are all in us. There's power in us. Poise and confidence. Prosperity, elegance, and abundance. Wisdom and infinite intelligence. It's all within. And we've come to set it free. To make a mighty difference on this planet. And to change the world for the better. Let's be this. Let's do this. In the here and now. Together. And so it is. Amen. Touch and agree. Handshake, high five, hug, glance into the eyes, whatever it takes. But feel the sacred agreement of your heart and soul that you are more than what you think you are. You're more than what has been said about you. You're more than your earthly experience. That there's something about you that is so profoundly magnificent and beautiful, eternal and timeless. And that something about you is the real you. And that you've come to be reminded about that truth week after week after week. And then begin to embrace your spiritual practices. So that this, which is a truism, becomes the truth of your being and becomes the sacred law of your life. It does not do any good to know that water will, of course, clean your body and, of course, allow for the thirst to be abated if you don't drink it or you don't wash in it. It's just something that you know about. So to simply know about that truth that your life is indeed the life of God, that you are an individualized expression of the Most High, it's good to know all of that. But unless it becomes the activity of your awareness and your sacred and personal law, is just simply information that has no transformational value. And so you are here in a community of practitioners. I'm not speaking merely of licensed practitioners. I'm speaking of individuals who take classes, who pray, who meditate, who vision, who serve, who share. Individuals who are opening themselves up to the activation of the hidden potential that's within us all. So that we can grow to become who we're meant to be. Not what we should be, but what we're meant to be. What we're meant to be comes from God lodged in your own soul. What you should be comes from external authority figures that have other agendas for you. You don't want to be what you should be. You want to be what you're meant to be by the presence of God that is in the midst of you. And we're all meant to be magnificent and great. We're all meant to shine the light of the divine. We're all meant to activate, cultivate, and express our talents, gifts, and capacities. We're all meant to come to a higher standard of living way beyond what society demands of you. To come to a higher standard of living and being and sharing and creating, that as I said earlier, we become a beneficial presence on the planet and change the world for the better. Now this begins with the context for our life. The theme of the month is your context determines your perception. And then it says, and you have it all. So as we were talking a little bit about in the morning session, the morning meditation session, that your context of how you live your life always determines your perception. And so the uninitiated, those who are asleep to the sleeping giant within their own being, oftentimes their context is merely, I'm merely human. Their context is merely around their gender or their race. The context is merely around where they were born, the astrological chart, around the numerology. The context is merely around the human experience, so their perception is narrow. The context by which you view your life in the sacred cosmology of oneness is that you live, move, and have your beingness in God. That's your context, you see? Timeless, dimensionless, no beginning, no ending, unaltered by time and space and experience. Your context is that you're living and moving and having your being in a brilliant light. Beauty, love, joy, wisdom, harmony, abundance, elegance, divine order. That's your context. Then your perception that emanates from your context is that you've got it all in the midst of you. And then your other identities, the other ways that you walk on the planet, are fired up by your expanded context. So you're not merely human. Your human incarnation is a magnificent instrument through which the eternal gets to come into time through all of your dynamic human incarnation. Your gender, your ethnicity, your culture, all of that gets to be a point of revelation for the eternal. And so from this moment on, you're going to begin to understand that your context is that you're living, moving, and having your beingness in the presence of God. The presence of God is having its being in, through, and as you, as the wave bear witness to the ocean, and the ocean reveals itself as the wave. Your life bears witness to the eternal, and the eternal reveals itself and personalizes itself as your life, so that everything that God is within you. Oh, I want you to feel this now, because if your context is large enough, your perception will change. So as we were practicing a little bit this morning, I want you to imagine for a moment, this is the right use of your imagination, by the way, that this infinite void of infinite possibility, the womb of creation, dark and dank and unmanifest, that carries a tremendous bliss of life and ecstasy and order and all of these names that we put on the qualities of the eternal. Imagine for a moment that before time began. Now, time is the measurement of experience, and time is the measurement of the distance between objects. Time disappears when your context is large enough to see that everything is here and now, and that there's no distance in your awareness. Now, you should just take the tape home and listen to that about 3 or 4 or 5, 6 times, okay? We'll break that down. So before time began, as we know it from the human context, this infinite presence is. And out of a dynamic enthusiasm and ecstasy and bliss, birthed itself in time and space as the grand cosmos, with universes and galaxies within those universes, and solar systems and living biology and star system and quarks and all that is in the manifest realm. And imagine for a moment that all of that is in your awareness. You may not think about yourself that way from time to time. You might think, I'm just a little old human being. I got a mom and a dad, and I had some ancestors, and I'm moving and shuffling on the planet, and hopefully I'm not going to die too soon and have some stuff before I die. No. All of that is within you. All of it is within your awareness as you expand your context. Your perception expands, and now you can begin to say, within me, I've got it all. I'm made of star dust. I'm living intelligence. by which the dust of the stars formed the body temple, that I can reveal the sacred light emanating from the fire of the central flame of all creation. Now, as your context continues to widen and deepen with spiritual practice, your personal law becomes, I've got what I need. I've got it all. Everything is working together for my good. I don't have to see it visually. I've got to feel it in my heart. I've got to walk with it. I've got to talk with it. And now I'm emanating. I'm radiating that frequency and that vibration. And then the universal law begins to act upon that frequency and vibration. Remember, our biggest language is frequency. You can hear people say the same thing and you can feel the frequency and they mean something totally different. Somebody's saying the same thing somebody else is saying, but one person is sarcastic and another person is loving and they're saying the same sentence. So our language is frequency. And the universe picks up on that frequency and begins to manifest the law of your frequency. Say with me now, I've got it all. It's all within me. All the good, all the peace, all the beauty, all the abundance, all the love, the elegance. It's all within me right now. And I'm here to set it free. My perception is expanding with every breath that I take. Because my context is I'm living in God. And God is living through and as me. And so as we dive into this throughout the course of this month, you're going to come to a greater awareness that your context by which you live determines your perception and begins to determine the content of your consciousness. Because if you're just little old insignificant person, then the thought forms that you are obtaining and sticking to you are thought forms that are vibrating at that perception. As you expand your perception, oh, the presence of God is in me, through me, and as me, I live, move, and have my beingness in God. Now the thought that is emerging in you, the thoughts you obtain, are coming from the infinite mind called inspiration. And the thoughts that stick through you and in you and as you are the inspired thoughts of God that vivify you, that makes you strong and capable in order to deliver the gifts that you are here to deliver. Yes. Say with me once again, my context, determines, my perception. And so as we feel into that, we take a breath here and just feel into that. So much within you. So much within you. So much within you. Now I'm going to ask for your help right here. I'm in a flow, but I need to know the topic of the day. Give me the first word. Gift. Oh, that's really good. Yeah, that's good. That's good. Good. Now, in other words, our life is a gift from the divine. This is very important, that you didn't generate yourself into expression. That who you are is an emanation of the Spirit. Who you are is an emanation of the Spirit. Who you are is an emanation of the Spirit of the living God is God's gift of itself as its own life personified as you. And so as you begin to embrace your life as a gift, then the pseudo sense of entitlement begins to dissolve and humility and gratitude begin to emerge. I'm talking about that pseudo entitlement, you know, that I just deserve this and I just deserve that. No, your life is a gift. Yes. And so when we begin to embrace it as a gift, humility, which is the fulcrum of power, begins to settle in our awareness. And from the deep and pure sense of humility, all the power of the universe can begin to flow through us because it is moving through a real sense of gratitude. And so I have humility because imagine somebody just giving you a great gift. They've given you a gift, you know, and you have to receive the gift, and so you're open, you're humble, and you're grateful. You're not, well, I deserve that gift, yeah. They should have given me that birthday present, yeah. I was born. I should have got that gift, yeah. No. No pseudo entitlements like, thank you. I'm humble. I'm available. Now the power of the universe, as I receive the gift, as I embrace the gift, as I'm grateful for the gift of life, I wake up, I'm grateful for this gift of life. I'm humble. Humble leads to a level of gratitude. And from gratitude, there's a greater sense of receptivity. Receptivity then leads to, I've got a lot to share. He or she who is given much, much is expected. This is what it says scripturally. He or she who is given much, much is expected. And so from humility and gratitude and receptivity, I've got a lot to share. I've been given the entire cosmos within me. I've been given all of the peace and harmony and wholeness within me. I've got a lot to share. And so as you move with humility, this happens with meditation and prayer. As you move with gratitude, this is augmented through meditation and prayer. You end up, I got a lot to share. Now, what will happen by law? If, in fact, you begin to let go of simply appeasing the acquisitive appetite of which you've inherited at times from the world, the suggestions of the world around lack and limitation, immature competition, not enough to go around, I got to get in order to be happy. What happens when you abate the acquisitive appetite and replace it with, I've got a lot to share. I've got a lot to give. I've got a song to sing. I've got some expression. Now the law begins to say, you've got a lot to give. You've got a lot to share. There's so much in you to be set free. We're going to help you activate it. We're going to cultivate it. We're going to create things in time and space that's going to jettison you to the next level. Why? Because you've got a lot to share. Say it, I've got a lot to share. I've got a lot to give. I've got a lot to radiate. So much good is trying to emerge through me. Now, this is very important because, as you've heard me say from time to time, you've arrived on earth at a very interesting time in human history. You arrived on earth in which the old is giving way to the new, but the old's trying to hold on. It's trying to hold on in a braggadocio kind of ways. It's trying to hold on in ignorant kind of ways. And you've arrived on earth not to merely fight the old, but you've arrived on earth with a lot to give, a lot to share, and your deep humility and gratefulness to articulate what's trying to emerge in you. And what's trying to emerge in your nation, what's trying to emerge on emerge on the planet, you're trying to say, we got a lot to give, and we're not going to be stymied with the past. In other words, though the old paradigm is shouting words of Islamic phobia, though the old paradigm is shouting words of Mexican phobia, and though the old paradigm is shouting a phobia against facts, and though the old paradigm has a phobia against the planet and climate change, though the old paradigm is just release the laws that's used to say you couldn't dump toxic waste in the ocean, and those laws have been repealed for the coal industry to flourish again. We don't want the coal industry to flourish. We want the coal industry to die to give way to clean energy. You see? And so the old people say, well, what are you guys going to do for a job? You're going to go into the millions of new jobs in clean energy. That's what you're going to do. We're not going to keep the typewriter corporations going when we got computers. Give me a break. And so, listen, you've arrived on planet Earth. Even though some are saying we're making great again, it looks like we're trying to make America hate again. We don't want that. You are the ones who are waking up and are saying the context by which I view my life is I'm living, moving, and having my beingness in God, which means as I expand my perception, I'm available to the mighty miracle of God moving through me in ways that I can't even begin to imagine. I don't have to hold on to the old because behold, I make all things new. Moment by moment by moment by moment, there's an emergence of infinite possibilities, and you don't have to protect the old paradigm. You've got to midwife it and then bury it. So that the new paradigm emerges in a way that progress and unfoldment continue to take place. So when you begin to embrace that, you're not entitled because you have a gift. You have a gift, therefore you are entitled to share what is within you. You're entitled to share. I've got a lot to share. I've got a lot to give. I've got a song to sing. There's movement in me to share. And now I can look at the old screaming to stay alive, and I can begin to embrace the new, find my place where the old is rapidly dying and the new is rapidly emerging, and walk step by step, bringing eternity on the planet, that which is eternal on the planet, in the world, changing the world with every breath that I take. Behold, everything is being made new. You've got power. You've got power within you. You've got power. And so you will transmute the anger and the righteous indignation, and it is righteous indignation, into steps, conversations, points of view that speak to what's rising. What's rising in you? What wants to rise in you? And then you'll bear witness to the truth that a new heaven and a new earth is seeking to emerge. And all flesh shall see it together. First in dreams, then in visions, then in form. And so you open yourself up, you say, I got a lot to share. And when you go to bed at night, you say, show me what I've got to share. Then you'll be given a vision and then assignments and action plans according to your gifted nature. Everyone has different gifts and talents. Everyone is the image and likeness of God, but God didn't do cookie cutters. God did unique expressions of infinite potential. What is it mine to do? And then you're lifted up into that vibration. Now, where does this begin and end? It begins with your spiritual, begins and ends with your spiritual practice. To be momentarily enthused is wonderful for the body temple. It's a great thing. But ultimately, there must be a consistent practice of what you say you believe, so that in the bone of your bones, in the very flesh of your flesh, the very woof and warp of your being, you know something. So how does that show up? Confidence. How does that show up? Poise. How does that show up? Peace. You carry. Imagine that you just had an encounter with the presence of God. And God laid out for you before the beginning of time all that you are, all that you're meant to be, and touched you with such brilliance and light. Imagine how you would walk on the world if, in fact, that encounter had occurred. Now, what I want you to begin to do is to walk on the world like that now. I want you to begin to walk on the planet and say, woo, I've been touched by the divine presence. I'm loaded and coated with infinite potential. Everything that I need and hope for and desire is within me. Everything is working together for my good, even if I can't see it in this moment with my eyesight. Begin to walk in that dynamic. And as I said earlier, you will be evoking a law of mind and action that wraps itself around that particular frequency, your gratitude and your humility and your how can I serve vibration and frequency will allow you to be the grand instrument. And we will make the world great again, not make the world hate again. You see. time to evoke the most powerful presence on the planet, and that's love. And not see it as a sweet, syrupy, sentimental emotionality, but to see it as the emanation from the presence of God, a total giving of itself without any sense of withhold, to love your neighbor as yourself. And it begs two questions. How much do you love yourself? And who is your neighbor? The neighbor isn't just the person living next door to you, even though there may need to be some work there. But your neighbor is everyone on this planet. And as your consciousness expands, it'll be everyone in the cosmos. They've now discovered a bunch of planets that look just like Earth in a whole nother galaxy. Wait till you meet those folks. They can't wait to meet you. Talk about ancestors coming from the same lineage. Oh, I wonder what they look like. But they're all from God. Take the breath. Release. Eyes open prayerfully. Begin to sit up straight in your chair and feel right now as if somebody just handed you a check for $100 million. Feel it. You're not going to go crazy and buy a bunch of stuff. 20 cars and 10 houses. No. Just feel what it feels like to have all of that, whatever that means. You see, just feel right now that from the time you were born, somebody came to your crib, and every single day of your life, as you began to understand language, they whispered in your ear, "You're significant, you matter, you're important. You took an incarnation because the world needed you. There's so much within you. You come from a lineage of enlightened avatars. And you are here as the latest iteration of an enlightened being on the planet, this time in human history." Do you realize they whispered that in His Holiness the Dalai Lama's ear ever since he was born? They said, "You're the Dalai Lama, you come from this lineage." What if we were all told that? You know what I mean? We, every single day, "You're great, you're magnificent, you have everything you need. There's safety around you, we got you covered, there's security around you. You have all of your needs met, your food, everything is here for you." I want you to imagine what that would feel like. This is how you re-engineer your imagination to be used by the presence of God. So imagine you've got all the money you need, and imagine someone told you from the time you were born that you were great. Significant. You arrived on planet Earth because you're needed. You are the next iteration of a lineage of sacred beings who are awakening to make a mighty difference on the planet with so much to give. Now, as you are allowing your imagination to run wild in that awareness, your body temple is trying to catch up with you. Really? I've been having bad posture. I thought I was just a little old, insignificant human being. My mother left me, mom, bad school systems. You mean really? Body temple's starting to catch up. Your emotional body is catching up. Your mental body is catching up. You can go ahead and smile. It's all right. Your face is starting to catch up with you. It's like, oh, really? Now, what came first, the chicken or the egg? When you shift your consciousness, you don't wait for all the good stuff to happen. It's already happened before the beginning of time. The good stuff is waiting for you. It's waiting for you. So I'm trying to get in. I'm trying to get in, but there's no vibrational match. I'm trying to get in there and express to them, but they're walking around like, oh my God, I'm just merely human. No, all of the infinite good is waiting for you to create a vibrational match so it can jump in. Now, make your life great again. Make your neighborhood great again. Make your world great again. Even though there are forces trying to make you hate again, you're gonna make your life great again. We're not going to succumb to Islamic phobia, gay phobia, Mexican phobia. We're not going to have a phobia against facts. We're going to embrace the truth and the true nature of our being. And then say, what would you have me be? What would you have me do? What am I meant to be? Let me be that. Breath. Sustain the breath right there. While you're sustaining the breath, re-engineer your imagination and imagine what your life would look like if someone told you you were great every single day of your life and if you had all of your needs met from the time you were born. Release. That reality exists within you. The other reality is a time frame of experience. You're making a, catch this, quantum leap from the world of experience, where you have experienced lies, into the reality of your being that's untouched by time. Are you catching that? Okay? It's a quantum leap. That's what prayer does. Takes you out of time. Quantum leap. Oh, this is who I am. That's what meditation provides the context for. Oh, I see. There's a part of me, my real self, not touched by time. It's a leap of faith and conviction. And as we're all creating a center of coherence, allowing our heart to beat with possibility, it's changing the fabric of reality as we know it. In our body temple, our mental body, our neighborhoods, our planet, we're changing the fabric of reality as we know it. We're rising up vibrationally. All shall see it together. First in dreams, then in visions, intuition, and then it clothes itself in form. Breath, release. Breath, release. Breath, sustain, feel that all of your needs are met, feel that you have a magnificent assignment, feel that you have so much to share, feel that you are a gift and that your life is a gift that you are moment by moment by moment receiving and accepting with humility and gratitude, release. You're now in the fulcrum. This humility is the fulcrum of power. Pseudo-entitlement is dissolved. And I'm grateful I get to share and give. I'm grateful I get to live. I'm grateful. I am entitled to share. And with this awareness, we move through the stages of how to deal with phenomena. Grace, one affirmation is, so what? The next affirmation is, it's not so. The next affirmation is a question, what's a so? Spirit reveals what's so. The next one is awesome. And then we come to the supreme affirmation. I am. I am. I am. Say it, I am.
I am.
I am.
I am.
I am. So you have your gift, your life, and the supreme affirmation, I am. So when I say these words, you say, I am love,
I am.
Peace,
I am.
Joy,
I am.
Prosperity,
I am.
Wisdom,
I am.
Abundance,
I am.
Opulence,
I am.
Intelligence,
I am.
Creativity,
I am.
Life,
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 I am.
Living,
I am.
Life,
I am.
Living,
I am.
Life,
I am.
Joy,
I am.
Beauty,
I am.
I am. Our gift, the gift, and the supreme affirmation, I am what thou art, and thou art what I am. And so we stop in this moment and we give thanks. We give it. Give it up. Just grateful. Don't withhold it. We don't hide our light under a bushel. Put it on top of the mountain. Let it shine. I am. And so it is in this consciousness of gratitude and thanksgiving, it supersedes the surface mind, its complaints, the surface mind's opinions, the surface mind's limited point of view. We come into the great gratitude. Oh my God, we open the door and we come into the room and there we meet, oh my God, all of the saints, all of the awakened beings are right here. The door is open. We're in the vibratory frequency of such gratitude, and we come into a whole new world. Here it is. It's a whole new world. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. We're so unified in this space that we get to bring this world, this expanded awareness, onto this planet. We're having a near-life experience. Oh, Lord. Infinite Spirit, great God of the universe, how wonderful and magnificent is thy holy, holy name, thy divine nature in us and as us. How great it is to be awake, aware, and alive, and to know even now as the word is spoken, something wonderful is happening. We feel so unified in this divine presence that the word that is being spoken is its sacred law. Does not tarry with yesterday. Does not deny the greatness that is within us. Does not hold on to worst case scenarios about the future. No, 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 no. We re-engineer our imagination as an angel of God and begin to see the great possibilities for our life. All life. Oh, Infinite Spirit, we surrender. Infinite Spirit, we let go. Infinite Spirit, we yield to more good than we could possibly imagine. Word is spoken that we have the dynamic health that is necessary for us to deliver our gift.
Yes.
The clarity of mind to deliver who we are. The purity of our emotional body that becomes an exact opening for the sacred qualities of the spirit to express through. The body of our affairs, order. Harmony, peace, elegance. And that includes our entire environment, our neighborhoods, our cities, our nations, the world, the planet. It is all now. We're seeing that which is real above the fray of human condition. Seeing it. Letting it be revealed through our life. People people are saying, God, please, please come down and help us. And God is saying, please rise. Please rise and reveal me in time. I'm counting on you to reveal me, says the Holy One. And so it is in this consciousness that we just hang in gratitude and thanksgiving. Let's hang here. Make your baby help them hang for a moment.
Early morning invitation. Let a prayer rise with the sun. Can my heart be free again to live, to love as best I can, and then place all things in God's hand?
Guide me.
take the hand of the being next to you. Feel the dynamic. You don't have to stand up. Just take the hand and just feel the field that is right here at Agape. Just feel the field. This field of prayer, sacred to meditation, undergirded by the supreme affirmation, I am. It is from this consciousness that we speak the word for Peggy Zimmerman, Cheyenne Kidd, William Chin's mother, Iris, Christy Hagen's for her mother, Sally, Enoch Freeman for and family for mother, Shirley, Kyle Robinson, Julie Reed Leeds, Yaji, Carrie LeBlanc's friend Adam, who made the transition to life after life. Peace for Carrie. Jeannie Lambert and family for their son Dallas. Peace be still. Susan and Saida for father and grandfather Bernard made the transition. Giselle Acuna and family for Mother Angel. Peace. 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 Be still. If you're holding anyone in prayer right now, just think about them. Just think about them and release a silent prayer on their behalf. Embrace your own life. All that you need is within you. Embrace your own life. You've got it all. Your context is your living, moving, and having your beingness in God. And so we give thanks. We give thanks. We give thanks. And we let it be. Now, when? Now, now, right now. And so it is. And so we let it be. Amen. Amen. Shalom. Salam. Ashe. Aho. Hallelujah. Now, so be it. It is done. It is done.